All right, so if you are ready, I'm starting the timer. All right, timer has I've started, and here is the question. Right, so if you've read and understood, kindly begin your examination.
I will wash my hands and I will
Yes.
introduce myself. My name is Dr. Mavish. I'm one of the surgical candidates today. Can I confirm your name and your age, please?
I'm Thomas, 23 years old.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Thomas. So today I'm going to examine your shoulder joint. This will include me looking at it, feeling it, and then asking you to do some movements, and I will also do some movements for you on your shoulder. Do you have any pain anywhere?
No.
Okay, if you feel any uncomfortable or any pain, just let me know. Are you happy for me to proceed?
Yes.
Okay, so the patient's position initially the patient can be sitting or standing. The exposure should be the patient's shirt should be off. Then I will start my examination by looking at the patient's shoulder, and on looking at it, I would look for if there is any deformity, if there is any scar marks, if there is any muscle wasting, especially looking at the gluteus muscle, and looking at the supraspinatus trapezius, these muscles, and then I would be looking for if there is from the front side, I would look for any if there is any inequality on both the shoulder joint. Then I would ask the patient if they can put their hands onto the wall and walk towards the wall, and I will look from the back. This is to look for the serratus interior, if there is any abnormal shape of the scapula, which could be the winging of scapula in the cases of long thoracic nerve injury. Then I would ask the patient that I'm going to now touch your shoulder joint. So I will start with the by assessing the temperature. So I will check the temperature with the back of my hand, and I compare it with the surrounding skin for any change in the temperature. Then I will start palpating. First of all, starting with the sternocleidomastoid joint to the clavicle, then to the ball of the shoulder joint, and then the acromion and the acromion process of the acromion process, then to the spine of the scapula, and then I will palpate the medial border of the scapula as well.
Good.
Then I would after finishing this, I would ask the patient that if they can raise their they can lift their hand from their side up to above their head. This will include me inspect looking at the patient's abduction, and then the range of the movement. Then I will ask the patient to put their hand by their side, and then bend their elbows toward their shoulders to look for the flexion, and then bend them straighten them to look for extension. I ask the patient to take their arms to the back and try to touch the back of their scapula, and then to look for the to the internal rotation. Then I would start the special test with the patient. So first of all, I would do the Jobs test. So this is for the rotator. These tests are for the rotator cuff injury first. So the Jobs test, in which I will ask the patient to raise their to abduct their arms for the arm for the 90 degree, then flex it about 30 degrees, and then thumb pointing downward. I will put my hand onto the patient's hand and ask them to press them up against my hand to look for the supraspinatus injury. If the supraspinatus is injured, the patient will have a difficulty doing this test. The next test would be the external rotation test. In this test, I will ask the patient to bend in their elbows at 90 degrees. I will put my one hand on the outside of the patient's elbow and one hand onto the inside of the patient's wrist. And I'll ask the patient, on the outside of the patient's wrist, and ask the patient to move their arm outside to check for the external rotation of the of the arm. This is to test the infraspinatus muscle. Then I would ask the patient, I will put my one hand onto the patient's elbow and other hand to the inside of the wrist. Ask the patient to press towards their belly. This is the belly press test, which is for the infraspinatus again. Then I would ask the patient to internally rotate their arm to their back, and then I will put my hand onto the patient's wrist and ask them to press down. This is for the supraspinatus. This is called the supraspinatus test. Then I would do the test for the called the apprehension and relocation test.
Empty can test.
I would do the apprehension and the relocation test. So for this, I would ask the patient to raise their hand to the actually abduct their hand to the 90 degrees, then externally rotate the elbow. This is 90 degree abduction. The elbow will be flexed and then externally rotated. The patient will start to feel pain. Then I will press onto the anterior part of the shoulder joint, and the pain, the patient's pain will be gone. So this is the relocation with the apprehension test. I will ask the patient to I will do this test one by one on one arm and on the other arm. I will ask the patient to move their arm and try to touch the other shoulder. This is for the acromioclavicular joint injury. In the cases of trauma, this is called scarf test, and then I will do the same with the other side. There's another test which is called the knee impingement test. In this, I will put my hand onto the back of the patient's scapula and then ask the patient to raise their hand and as far as they can. If there is pain, this means there is the impingement, nerve impingement.
Very good. Can you summarize your case now, please?
My patient, the pharmacist, is 23 years old, who is an athlete, which and it came with the pain in the shoulder joint, with the pain in the shoulder joint, and the I don't know the findings yet. So the patient rotation is having problem in the rotation of the arm, rotating it above the 60 to 120 degrees, and patient's apprehension test is positive.
Okay.
So my differential diagnosis for this patient, if the patient is having a frozen shoulder or the anterior arch syndrome.
Yes, painful arch.
Painful arch syndrome.
Yes. Okay. What would you do to complete your examination?
So I would to complete my examination, I would like to do the neurovascular examination of the upper limb, and I would also like to examine a joint below, which is the elbow joint and the wrist. So.
Okay, and cervical spine as well.
Yes, I will also check the cervical spine of this patient.
Yes. Yes. Okay. What investigations should be done?
So the investigation should be done radiologically. It should be the X-rays, and the ideal X-ray views are the epilateral view in the neutral position, scapular bio view, or it could be the we can also do the lateral view and the AP view in the internal external rotation. MRI and arthrography can also be done. And the treatment for this for the shoulder, frozen shoulder, is the we can either do the conservative management with the pain relief, NSAIDs, or physiotherapy, intrasteroidal injection, or we can do the these are the things we can do. And also we can do the distension arthrography, and on the surgical side we can do the manipulation under anesthesia, or we can do the arthro.
If during examination you realize that patient has a torn rotator muscle, what would you advise the patient?
Torn rotator muscle. So we need to either repair it. So
what would be your advice to the patient?
So the torn rotator cuff muscle, then we have to ask the patient to I don't know if we can mobilize it or not. I'm not
Let's
sure about
hear.
That.
Yes.
Arthroscopy guided repair, I guess.
Yes.
And also okay. Depends on the age of the patient.
Depends, yes. Okay, this one repair. Was a young fellow. So athlete,
yeah.
Maybe was
playing. This needs repair.
Yes. So how much rest would you advise this patient with rotator muscle injury?
6 months?
More or less, yes. Until patient complains of pain, yeah. Very good. Excellent. You took a little longer, but you were like going like a bullet. It was good. Excellent. Did you remember to examine teres minor?
I think I did.
Maybe you did, but I think I missed. External rotation and abduction, hornblower sign. Maybe you did. I'm not sure.
I didn't do the hornblower sign because I don't know this.
Okay. This
it's for teres minor.
Yeah.
And at least, if you have time, check the badge area sensation. For axillary nerves.
Okay.
Yes. Good. Excellent. Anyone else want to add anything? Something like shoulder examination came, so I thought, okay, let's.
It came
practice.
Twice. It came on 4th, and it came to Asra
as well. 7th. Yeah. So it came in Dublin and it came in here in UK as well, Sheffield, what Dr. Sunday told. So it's better to practice, right? Good.
Dr. Samin, if you don't mind, if I can do the second one as well. My